Gurave Namaha. Namo Vishnupadaya Krishna Pristaya Bhutale Srimati Bhaktivedanta Swami Niti Namine. Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pricharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacya Desatarine. Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhaevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadara Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Rama Hare Hare. So, we're hearing about Gop Kumar, the cowherd boy from Govardhan, and how he's using his mantra to travel to different places.
讲述的是来自高尔丹山的一位牧牛从多帕库马，他骑着一首mantra，旅行到不同的地方。So
we heard how Gop Kumar had come back to Vrindavan, and he'd met his guru, and his guru had given him a lot of instruction about the mantra and how to chant the mantra.
他回到了Vrindavan，遇见自己的guru。
So after his guru instructed him, then the guru disappeared, and then Gop Kumar was left to travel, and he journeyed out of the universe.
他的guru给予他信誓之后呢，就变消失了。
We heard how he traveled very quickly. He traveled past all the higher planets in the universe.
上节课我们讲到，他速度非常快，很快就超过了，就是穿过了这个宇宙的所有高等星系。
Previously, he had spent time on each of these higher planets, but this time he just went right past them.
在之前呢，他曾经在每一个就高等星宿呢都停留一段时间，可是这一次呢，他就是直截了当的，就也没有停顿，直接就超过了这些高等星宿。So
he came. He wanted to go to the abode of liberation. He wanted to go through the covering of the universe. So he came through the different coverings of the universe. He was, you know, first of all, he came through the earth covering, and then he came through the water covering, then the fire covering.
首先呢，他是穿过了土这一个覆盖层，下一个是水的覆盖层，再下一个是火的覆盖层。
And he had to give up, his body transformed from material, it transformed to a transcendental kind of spiritual body. Then he came, as he came through the covering, he came into a place that was brilliantly effulgent, very bright light. He had to close his eyes.
下一个地方呢，就是一片白茫茫的强光，这光芒如此的强烈，以至于他不得不闭上了眼睛。
And then as he came through that light, then he came, he saw the, then he was able to see the Supreme Lord.He was able to see the Lord along with the Lord's prakriti, the Lord's material nature.
在这尊主旁边呢，是这尊主的 prakriti 物质本性。
So when he saw the Lord, he didn't know what to do. He was feeling so much reverence and fear, and at the same time happiness.He didn't know what to do, how to react.
当他戈巴库马尔见到至尊主之后，他也不知道该作何反应。他怀着敬畏的心情，与此同时，他内心感到很快乐，但他却不知道该怎么办。
He knew that nobody can see him. We can't see the Lord without the mercy of the Lord.We can't see the Lord just simply by the power of our own senses. It's only by the Lord's mercy that one is able to see Him.
一个人不能靠自己的感官见到至尊主的，只有藉着主的仁慈，一个人才能见到至尊主。
So Gop Kumar wasn't, he couldn't, he didn't know if he was actually seeing Him with his eyes, or if it was just within his mind, or maybe it was justHe thought maybe it's just a power of the soul.
Gopakumar 知道自己是用自己的眼睛看见了至尊主呢，还是通过心意看见至尊主，还是藉着灵魂的力量看见了至尊主。
So one moment he would see him, he would see the Lord as being formless, but then he would remember the mercy of Lord.Jagannath, and you see him again, and then you see him again in his personal form.
一开始呢，他看见的至尊主他是没有形象的，之后看见的就是主迦格纳的形象，再之后他看见了主的本人，他的个人形体。
He appeared to be.Without a form, because he was so bright, the effulgence coming from his body was so great that Gop Kumar couldn't see anything but the effulgence coming from his body. So it appeared like he had no form. So this is the nature of the abode of liberation, because in the abode of liberation, there's only like the oneness. So you just see everywhere the light, everything is just light.
This is the nature of the abode of liberation, because in the abode of liberation, there's only like the oneness.
So Gop Kumar, when he saw that, he remembered Lord Jagannath, because Lord Jagannath was also very effulgent. When he had gone to see Lord Jagannath, he remembered how Lord Jagannath had a brilliant effulgence. And he thought that nobody else could be as merciful as Lord Jagannath.
这之后，他想起了主迦格纳的。因为主扎巴纳的身体也是放射着光芒，因为主扎巴纳除了主扎巴纳的之外呢，没有人像他那么仁慈了。
So sometimes he could feel himself merging into the Lord's effulgence, but then the Lord would save him, because the Lord would touch him with the nails of his lotus feet. And so it would, then Gop Kumar would stop merging into the effulgence.
有时候他感觉自己好像要融入了这个光芒之中，但是至尊主就用他的脚趾甲触碰他，就把他给从这种境况当中拯救出来，使他停止融入主的光彩中。
The devotee never wants to give up the relationship with the Lord.
至尊主的奉献者永远不会放弃跟主的关系。
And when the Lord's lotus feet touch the devotee, then the devotee feels so much ecstasy, so much pleasure. They never think about merging.
当奉献者得到至尊主莲花足的触碰之后，他们感受到如此大的狂喜和快乐，他们再也想不到要融入主的光灿中了。
Yeah, we don't just only find the Lord's lotus feet attractive, everything about the Lord is attractive, but the attraction begins from his lotus feet.
不仅主的莲花足是最有吸引力的，有关于主的一切都是最有吸引力的，但是这种吸引是属于主的莲花足。
So sometimes Gop Kumar's mind would feel pleasure seeing the Lord with all of his devotees, because the Lord wasn't alone, he was surrounded with his devotees.
Gop Kumar 的内心因为看见主和主的所有奉献者而感到快乐，因为主永远不是独自一人的，他跟奉献者等在一起。
These devotees, they were all surrounding him, and they all had their subtle spiritual forms. They were like beams of light. They were like some different lights around the sun.
奉献者以他们精微的灵性形象呢，环绕着至尊主，就好像太阳四周的光芒。
So even in the abode of liberation, although in the abode of liberation there's only oneness, but even there the Lord also has his devotees with him. The only difference is in that abode of liberation, people don't have a real mood of service. You know, they just like to enjoy being with the Lord.
唯一的区别是在解脱之地呢，缺乏服务的心态，他们只是享受。
So it's the nature of, like, Shantarasa is like that. You just enjoy the beauty of the Lord, you don't do service. So Gop Kumar is feeling great ecstasy in this situation. He felt very, very satisfied, very fulfilled. Everything, all his desires had been, like all of his desires had been satisfied.
Gop Kumar 呢感到非常狂喜，他的心愿已经得到了满足，他非常的满意。
Yeah, because he's able to see the Lord. So this is what he always wants. He always wants to see the Lord.
因为他内心始终想要看见主，他的愿望夙愿就达成了。
So in this, he was thinking that he had reached the highest destination. He thought this is the perfection of life.
他认为自己已经达到了最高的目标，这就是生命的完美。
He had actually forgotten what his actual goal was. Because remember, Gop Kumar was a devotee. He'd been worshipping the Lord as Madan Gopal for a long time. So he has a special attraction for Madan Gopal.
Because Gopal Kumar 是 Madan Gopal 的奉献者， 长久以来一直深受到 Madan Gopal 的吸引。
So now he's only in the abode of liberation. He's in the place of impersonal liberation. So why does he think this is the goal?
现在他身处解脱之地，非人格的解脱，为什么他又认为这就是目标了？
Because this the nature of that place that is very confusing and that takes your mind away from the actual form of the Lord.
因为这个就是那里的本性，一个人会感到困惑，这个地方会把一个人的心意拿走，他们忘记了主的形象。
Yeah, because Gop Kumar, he wants to worship Madan Gopal. He doesn't want to worship just this brilliant, effulgent form of the Lord. He wants to worship the Lord in the threefold bending form, playing the flute.
Because Gop Kumar 崇拜的是 Madan Gopal, 可是现在呢，就他并不是要崇拜主的光芒四射的光彩，他想要崇拜的是有着三度曲线吹奏着笛子的主的形象。
So, although the impersonal feature, this effulgent form of the Lord was very powerful and very attractive and very confusing, but still he could never forget Madan Gopal.
虽然主的这种放射着万丈光芒、璀璨的、有着璀璨夺目光芒的这样的一个形象，是既有力量又令心，但是格帕库玛他是他的崇拜目标是马丹格帕。
So what he should actually do? He's in the abode of liberation.He needs to go on, he needs to travel higher, he needs to go through the abode of liberation. So because he'd always been faithful to the teaching and the instructions of his guru, he never lost the desire to come to Madan Gopal.
虽然他对自己咕噜的对自己咕噜满怀信心，对咕噜的信誓忠诚的遵守，他永远从来没有忘记过自己的心愿。
So when he would look at the form of the Lord, this very bright effulgent form of the Lord at this abode of liberation, thenIt would increase his greed for Madan Gopal.
虽然格帕库玛他现在注视着主的这个光芒万丈的放射着熠熠光彩的形象，但是这反而增加了他想要见到 Madan Gopal 的愿望。
So he could understand that this place where he was in this place, the abode of liberation, it was higher than Brahma Loka.
He 心里明白，他现在身处的这个解脱之地比 Brahma Loka 要更崇高。
And when he saw the Lord there, the Lord in the place of liberation is called Mahakala.So it increased, he was able to remember more Madan Gopal. He wants to see Madan Gopal not just in his heart, he wants to actually see him.
Madan Gopal, 还想用双眼亲眼见到
He doesn't want to just meditate on him. He wants to actually be with the Lord. So, Gop Kumar, although the Lord is right there before him, the Lord is in a different form here in the place of liberation. He's in the form of Mahakala. And so it could not really satisfy him. Now he was worried, he was afraid that he might merge into the form of the Lord, because that's what usually happens in that place. So Gop Kumar was not actually very happy at this place, not like the other planets he had visited. Other places he'd also seen the Supreme Lord, and but these other places he did not inspire him to remember Madan Gopal. But on these other planets, he never thought about merging into the Lord. He knew if he was going to merge into the Lord, he would forget his own existence, and he would forget about the joining the pastimes of Madan Gopal. So he was thinking, maybe he should return to Vrindavan. He was thinking, I can fulfill my desires if I go back to Vrindavan. So then, he heard some wonderful singing and music.
之后，他听到了一阵美妙的歌声，美妙的音乐。And
he saw Lord Shiva riding on a bull.
他看见主Shiva骑在一头公牛的背上。He
was coming from a higher place.
他来自于更高的地方。
So Lord Shiva's body is all covered with ashes, he's naked, and he has the half moon on his head. And his hair is all wet with the water of the Ganges. And he's got his wife with him, sitting on his lap. So Gop Kumar, of course, he doesn't. He's not so sure who is Lord Shiva. Doesn't recognize him. And Lord Shiva's got also Ganesh with him, Ganesh is one of the sons of Lord Shiva. You know, if you worship Ganesh, then you may get a form like Ganesh. You know, Ganesh has a big belly and he has an elephant head.
Ganesh 有着一个大大的肚子, 还有一个象头。
But when you worship Lord Shiva, you understand Lord Shiva is not different from Krishna.
但崇拜主Shiva, 他崇拜主Shiva, 他明白跟主Krishna没有分别。
And you get a beautiful, you can get a beautiful form on Lord Shiva's planet. So Gop Kumar is thinking, who is this? Who are all these people with him? And what are they doing in this place of liberation? This person, Lord Shiva, looks very powerful than anybody he's seen before, and he seems greater than even the liberated souls.
这个人物比他之前见过的任何人都更有力量，甚至超过了那些伟大的解脱的灵魂。
But he's not following the rule, the proper etiquette. It's like he's not even civilized. It's like he's a sense enjoyer, because he's naked and he's with his wife.
但是看上去他好像不遵守礼仪，而且好像是没有开化，像一个感官享乐者，因为他赤身裸体，还跟自己的妻子在一起。And
he's even embracing her in public.
他甚至在公开场合，公开的拥抱自己的妻子。Anyway,
Gop Kumar bowed down to him.
And
the people with him were very nice and they showed mercy to Gop Kumar. And so Gop Kumar approached to them and he asked about who is this person, what was he doing? So, when Gop Kumar asked this, then they laughed at him. They said, you don't know? You don't recognize Lord Shiva? He's the Lord of the universe. He gives enjoyment and liberation. He can give material enjoyment. He can also give liberation. And he can also increase devotion for the Supreme Lord. And he is worshipped by the liberated souls.
He's
very dear to the Vaishnavas. And he's a friend of Kuvera, and he's traveling with his wife Parvati, and they're going to Mount Kailash.
He
came from his own planet.
他从他自己的居所而来。
And he's not different from Lord Krishna.
他和主 Krishna 没有分别。
So Gopkumar is very happy to hear this.
Gopakumar 听到这一番话，感到十分的高兴。
He had a long desire to understand. He wanted to know about how Lord Shiva is not different from Madan Gopal.
长久以来，他一直想了解主 Shiva， 并且认识他跟 Madan Gopal 没有区别。
So he was very attracted to Lord Shiva.
因此，他受到主 Shiva 深深的吸引。
So Lord Shiva, he knows, he can understand what Gopkumar was thinking, and he told his assistant to guide Gopkumar and to explain everything about Lord Shiva to him.
主 Shiva 知道他的想法，他便让他的助手来指导 Gopakumar 了解主 Shiva。
Yeah, Lord Shiva helps to increase the love for the Supreme Lord.
主 Shiva 帮助一个人增加对至尊主的奉爱。
So, this way Gopkumar became one of Lord Shiva's companions. and they accepted him. They accepted him to come with them, to travel with them for a little while.
就这样呢，罗巴库马尔变成了主师傅的同游了，他的同游们也都接纳了他，跟他们旅行一段时间。
And they were telling Gopkumar some of the benefits of worshipping Lord Shiva, that he has only one form, he doesn't change his form all the time, like Vishnu or Krishna, but he has one form.
崇拜主 Shiva 的好处就是，他们解释了崇拜主 Shiva 的好处是主 Shiva 他的形象始终如一，不像主 Vishnu 和主 Krishna 那样不断变化的形象。
And he's always visible. His devotees can always see him. He doesn't go away and leave them. He's always with them.
而且主 Shiva 是始终可见的，他从来不离开他的奉献者。
And they have festivals of singing and dancing. This way the devotees get so much pleasure and they become greedy for service to the Lord. And although he's the Lord of the universe, he himself worships the Supreme Lord who is Shesha, who has 1,000 faces.
虽然他自己就身为宇宙之主，但是他崇拜着有着一千张面孔的 Shesha.
Yeah, Ananta Shesha is.Actually, the expansion of Lord Sankarshan.
Ananta, 名字叫 Ananta Shesha, 就是 Sankarshan 的扩展。
And both Ananta Shesha and Lord Shiva, they are in charge of the mode of ignorance.
无论 Ananta Shesha.还是主 Shiva， 他们都掌管着愚昧属性。
So Lord Shiva is a great devotee of Lord Sankarshan.
主 Shiva 是 Sankarshan 的伟大奉献者。
The snakes on the body of Lord Shiva, they represent Lord Sankarshan.
在主 Shiva 缠绕在主 Shiva 脖颈上的蛇代表着三块闪。
And Lord Shiva knows that his own existence came is because of Lord Sankarshan. So he always meditates on Lord Sankarshan.
主 Shiva 心里明白，他的存在是源于 Sankarshan， 所以他始终冥想 Sankarshan。
So we said Sankarshan expands as Ananta Shesha. And Ananta Shesha has thousands of heads, of hoods, you know, because in the form of the snake.
Ananta Shesha is Sankarshan's expansion. Ananta Shesha is 有着一千个头孔的蛇。
So we worship Lord Sankarshan to overcome false ego.
因此，我们崇拜三块善呢，以便克服假我。
Right, Lord Shiva's abode, Lord Shiva's place. This is the region of ahankar, of false ego. Lord Shiva is—he's overseeing the false ego. If we want to get free of false ego, we have to take shelter of Lord Shiva.
这个地方呢，就是 ahankar 的居所，假我居所。而主 Shiva 呢，是监管着这个 ahankar 假我。所以，如果我们要，If we want to overcome false ego, we have to worship Lord Shiva.
Yeah, take shelter of Lord Shiva, yeah.
如果我们想要克服假我，就要脱离于主 Shiva.
So when Gop Kumar was hearing about Shiva Loka, he was very happy. But still he knew this was not what he really wanted.
当他库玛尔听说到主 Shiva 的 Loka 之后，他感到十分的高兴，但是他明白这并不是他自己想要的。
Right, but then in the core of his heart, what he really wants is Madangopal.
在他内心深处，他真正想要的是 Madangopal。
So he was becoming, Gop Kumar was becoming a bit disturbed because he was forgetting about the lotus feet of Madangopal, and he was forgetting about Madangopal's pastimes and his other features. Because he was hearing about other people, about Lord Shiva and everything.
Gopakumar 他对于 Madangopal 有一点忘记了 Madangopal 的消失关乎他的特点，因为他听到其他人这样给他讲述主 Shiva。
So Gopakumar has to try to control his mind. He preaches to his mind. He's telling his mind that Lord Shiva is performing these wonderful pastimes in the form of Lord Gopal, that they're not different.That Lord Shiva and Madangopal are not different.
So, Gopakumar 还得劝说他自己的心意，告诉他的心意，主 Shiva 跟 Madangopal 没有区别。
But he knew there are some differences that in the form of Lord Madangopal.There's a special sweetness, a special beauty, which is not there in Lord Shiva. But still, he thinks that by Lord Shiva's mercy, he will get his desire fulfilled. He will be able to.See Lord Madangopal.
他也知道，一是主 Shiva 的仁慈，他能够满足他的愿望，想要见到 Madangopal 的愿望。
So like this, he said, my mind became happy and I was able to stay for a while with Lord Shiva and to take rest with them before going on to their journey.
他就劝告他的心意，哎，我的心意，你应该感到高兴。嗯，我就这样了，我们可以跟主Shiva待在一起一段时间。Right.
So then, while they were resting, then they could hear the sweet singing. They heard the great souls coming, singing beautiful songs, very sweet tunes, and Gop Kumar was wondered, what's that sound?
当他们休息的时候，可以听到动听的歌曲，美丽动听的歌曲，还有很美优美的曲调。那他郭宝心想，这是从哪里来的？
So when Lord Shiva heard the singing, he became very ecstatic, and all his ecstasy of love of God awakened. And he began to sing and dance all on his own.
当主Shiva听到这个美丽动听歌曲之后，立刻就狂喜起来，他的神爱马上就焕发出来，他开始一个人跳起舞来。
And so Lord Shiva's wife and his companions, they encouraged Lord Shiva. They began to play the music also, and they began to chant the Lord's names. So in this way, Lord Shiva became more and more enthusiastic to dance.
主Shiva的妻子和同游们也都鼓励着他，也开始弹奏着音乐，放松着，唱诵起来。这样主Shiva的热情就越来越高涨，他就越来越热情地开始跳起舞来。And
then he saw the four-armed people. All these people came, very beautiful, and they were young, and they were all nicely dressed and decorated, appeared very opulent, and they were chanting the holy name and dancing, performing the kirtan.
青春年少，他们在跳着舞，唱诵着圣名，在举行着kirtan。And
they were decorated and their bodies were very effulgent. They were so effulgent that it almost made like the followers of Lord Shiva, they became almost invisible due to the effulgence coming from the bodies of these people with the four arms.
他们浑身上下呢，就点缀着事物，并且放射着光芒。嗯，他们这些光芒使得主Shiva的追随者几乎就看不见了。And
then he saw also, along with these people with the four arms, there were the four Kumaras, the four sons of Brahma who he had met before, who are just like young boys, that they were also with them.
而且和这些长着四臂形象的人们在一起的是库马尔四兄弟，如Brahma的儿子，那些小男孩们。So
when Gop Kumar saw these people, he was so attracted to them, he couldn't think of anything else but them. He just became so absorbed in these people that, oh, they're so wonderful, they're so amazing. And he forgot about everything else.
当高巴库马看到他们的时候，深深的受到了吸引。他此刻已经想，再也想没有别的念头了。他完全专注于这些人，他们是这样的美丽奇异。So,
he wanted to become their servant, but he was too afraid or too embarrassed to ask them.
He wanted to become their servant, but he was too afraid or too embarrassed to ask them.
Lord Shiva, he would embrace them, and when he would embrace them, he would also he would swoon in love of God. He would become so ecstatic just by embracing their bodies.
主 Shiva 就拥抱了他们，仅仅是通过这个拥抱，他便浑身就被狂喜所充斥着。
So he, Lord Gop Kumar has a desire and thinks that maybe by the mercy of Lord Shiva, maybe these persons may talk to me, they may give me, they may show some kindness and speak some words to me. So Lord Shiva's wife, she was watching, and she could understand what Gop Kumar was thinking. And so she told Ganesh, her son, to talk to Gop Kumar. Yeah, so Ganesh tells her that these people are their associates of Lord Krishna from Vaikuntha. And they've got the same form like Krishna, and they have come from the Lord's place, from the Vaikuntha. They've come directly from the Vaikuntha. They're traveling in the universe on behalf of their Lord. They have come to deliver the message of the Lord to people in this universe. Yeah, because this is only a small universe. Brahma only has four heads. There are many bigger, much bigger universes. So they travel quite quickly. They don't spend much time.
这个宇宙呢，不大。主 Brahma呢，只长着四个头。
And Ganesh showed Gop Kumar how there are many people from Vaikuntha also traveling in the other universes. There are many, many universes, many big universes, and the Vaikuntha devotees are going there to distribute the glories of the Lord.
其他还有很多其他的外空塔的人们，他们在其他的宇宙来旅行，把外空塔的讯息派发给其他宇宙的人们。
Different universes, they have different kinds of bodies, so when they go to a universe, sometimes they have to change their body to suit that particular universe.
宇宙的人们呢，有着不同的躯体，因此这些人他们去到这些宇宙的时候，必须要变换他们的身体。But
their only business is devotional service, to do service for the pleasure of the Lord.
他们唯一的事物就是从事于对主做奉爱服务。
And they save the devotees from any kind of fear even at the time of death, if the devotees have some fear, they will come and they will save them. You know, just like the story of Ajamil, how Ajamil was chanting, said the name of the Lord, so the Vishnu Dutas came there and saved him.
We all know Ajamil's story, he sang the Vishnu Dutas' name, so Vishnu Dutas came to save him.
And he said the four Kumaras, these four brothers, he said they're also the Lord's incarnation. They're incarnations as devotees. And they wander everywhere also, just like the Lord's associates from Vaikuntha. They also go everywhere delivering Krishna consciousness.
他们也四处旅行，就像来昆达古德百昆达的同游们那样，到各处派发不是不知觉。
Yeah, they live on. They have their planet Tapaloka. Gokumar had visited there earlier. He'd gone there to Tapaloka.
他们也有自己的星球叫塔帕洛卡，在早先的时候，古巴库马尔曾经拜访过这个星球。
And they give security, they help people who feel, they may feel the absence of the Lord, but they help them to remember the Lord, but they all do meditation on the Lord, and they feel the Lord's presence by meditation.
不在的那种情况下呢，他们会向人们展示冥想，从而感受到主的亲身临在。So
these four Kumaras had just gone to Vaikuntha, and they'd seen the Lord there. They'd seen all of His wonderful qualities.
这四位库玛刚刚去过百昆塔，在那里见到了主，感受到了主的美丽的形象和他的品质。
And they had experienced that the ecstasy of devotional service or seeing the Lord was so much greater pleasure, so much more satisfying than any of the so-called happiness which comes from liberation.
所感受到的解脱的感受，有着更高的快乐和更让人感到更大的满足。
So in this way, Ganesh is describing the opulence of Vaikuntha. He said it's the ultimate limit of bliss, the greatest pleasure, the greatest happiness.
他们就这样，就是感恩时。就解释了这个百昆塔的富裕，声称这个是终极的极限了，在那里感受到了极乐的快乐。And
there in Vaikuntha, you can see all the time the pastimes of the Lord with the goddess of fortune, and with all the devotees. And they're engaging in wonderful pastimes together. But if somebody is attracted to this idea of merging or becoming one, the idea of the impersonal liberation, then they can never see these things. They will never be able to witness the Lord's pastimes.
If one person is attracted, 融入到，要融入到主的存在当中，受到非人格的解脱的吸引，受到义的意愿的吸引，他永远见不到，也永远无法目睹这些消失光。
Then Lord Ganesh tells Gop Kumar, he said, if you get the real mercy of my father, meaning Lord Shiva, said, then you will hear all about Vaikuntha and you will go there and see it for yourself.
然后 Ganesh 又告诉 Gop Kumar, 如果你得到了我的父亲主 Shiva 的仁慈，那你就能够从他口中直接聆听到去外昆特的荣耀，并且能够亲身去到外昆特。
So when Gop Kumar heard this, then he's very eager to go there, and his mind begins to feel so much ecstasy, and he's so much anxious to go there and to see this Vaikuntha.
当 Gop Kumar 听完这番话之后，他就非常的渴望去那里，他的心意非常想要去外昆塔。
But he thought, I'm not fit to go there. And so he cried. And he was so feeling so sorry. He thought, how can I go there? I'm not qualified. And then he fainted. And he fell to the ground.
他觉得可是 Gopa Kumar 感受到自己就没有资格。他就哭泣起来，他感到很难过，就想我如何才能去那里呢？他就这样就晕倒在地。
So then Lord Shiva who is very kind to the devotees, Lord Shiva cannot tolerate to see other people in distress, so he picked up Gop Kumar and he spoke to him.
主 Shiva 对奉献者最为仁慈，他无法容忍看到奉献者伤心难过，他便扶起了 Gopa Kumar。
And he says to Gop Kumar, Lord Shiva says to him, my dear Vaishnava, he said, you know, both my wife Parvati and I, we're just like you. We also want to live forever in Vaikuntha.
他对他说，我亲爱的 Vaishnava。Parvati 和我也是想永恒地居住在Vaikuntha。
Lord Shiva said, you know, it's very difficult to go there. Even liberated souls, they pray to go there.
主 Shiva 说，要想去那儿是难上加难的，即便解脱了灵魂，他们祈祷能够去那里。
Lord Brahma's sons and Lord Brahma himself, they're also trying to go there. And Lord Shiva said, even me also, I'm also trying to go there.
即便主 Brahma 的儿子和他本人也想去 Vaikuntha, 包括我自己在内也在努力地想去 Vaikuntha.
So then Lord Shiva describes the qualification to go there.
接下来主 Shiva 描述了去外昆特的资格。
He said, one who has completely perfected his religious duties.
一个人他倘若在他履行宗教职责方面达到了完美。
And he has no more selfish desires.
他也没不再有自私的欲望。
And who has that kind of purity, then he can get the mercy of the Lord.
一个拥有这样的纯洁心灵的人可以获得主的仁慈。
So then if that mercy is multiplied 100 times, you may get the position of Brahma. You have to be very pure to become Lord Brahma.
这种仁慈乘以100倍就能达到主 Brahma 的职位，他就能拥有这种纯洁。
And if you multiply the, you know, if you get to the position of Brahma, you have to become 100 times more pure to get my position, to become like me, like Lord Shiva. And if you get 100 times the mercy of what Lord Shiva has, then you can go to Vaikuntha. So you can understand how difficult it is to go there to Vaikuntha. But Lord Shiva tells Gop Kumar, he said, you deserve to go to Vaikuntha because you are the son of a cowherd boy from Govardhan. You're a devotee of the Lord of Mathura. And you're a disciple of a Brahmana who is very devoted to the Lord. And I know this guru of yours, he gave you this mantra by which you're traveling, by which you came here to my abode. So, you're very faithful in your service. I know you're very faithful to the Lord, so you deserve to go to Vaikuntha. He said, here, this place, this is the abode of Sayujya, merging, becoming one with the Lord. It's liberation, but it's not very desirable for devotees. This is the place for people who are, they've renounced the material world. Yeah, they've given up any desire to enjoy the material world. Yeah, they know all that the material world was all just some illusion, just temporary pleasures of illusion. So, but they have the people who come here, they have the desire to merge, to enter into the oneness, to give up their individuality. So Lord Shiva said, he said, it's by the order of Lord Krishna, I don't let them know about Prema Bhakti. I don't tell them about the pleasure, the greatest pleasure which is there in devotional service. I just let them go into the oneness and give up their individuality.
I
The Lord likes to keep devotional service very confidential. But devotees who know about the ecstasy of worshipping the Lord, they don't give any attention, they don't give any importance to this impersonal abode.
但是了解崇拜主带来的狂喜的奉献者并不重视这个非人格的居所。So
Lord Shiva tells Gop Kumar that this place is just an obstacle to your path of devotion.
主Shiva告诉欧帕库玛，这个地方仅仅是对你的奉爱。
And Lord Shiva gives the example about how the Brahmana was living in Dwarka and he wanted to taste Krishna Prem. So he brought his sons away from the abode of liberation. He brought them back to Dwarka.
一位 Brahmana 希望让他儿子们能够感受到 Krishna Prem， 于是便把儿子们带离了这个解脱之地。
Now, this story is told in the 10th canto Srimad Bhagavatam about how the Brahmana's sons were dying one after another, and then Krishna and Arjuna went to look for them, and they found them in the abode of liberation.
这个故事是在圣典《博伽瓦坛》第十篇当中记述的。那些有一位 Brahmana 的儿子们，Krishna， 一位 Brahmana 就让 Krishna 和 Arjuna 去帮他找回在解脱之地的他的儿子们。So
Krishna and Arjuna brought them back from there. They brought them back to Dwarka. Now they'd already achieved the abode of liberation. Why did they not leave them there? Because Dwarka is higher than the abode of liberation. So the Brahmana wanted his sons to get Krishna Prem. They can't get that in the abode of liberation. Anyway, by the power of your guru, the mercy of your guru, he gave you the mantra that you could come here, you could see the Lord here in the abode of liberation. That was his mercy.
由于你的Guru的仁慈，他给了你这首 mantra， 你可以来到解脱之地，见到主。And
then, by Krishna's mercy, you have the desire to see Krishna.
由于 Krishna的仁慈，你有这种想见到 Krishna的愿望。So,
Gop Kumar was very ecstatic to get this mercy of Lord Shiva. He wanted to say something, but he felt too shy. He didn't like to say anything. So in this way, hearing Lord Shiva's words, then the Vaikuntha Vasis, the people from Vaikuntha, began to speak. And they say that Lord Shiva is right. There's no difference between Lord Shiva and the Supreme Lord of Vaikuntha. There's no difference between Gauri and Rama. Gauri means the wife of Lord Shiva, and Rama means Rama Devi, the goddess of fortune.
他们说，主Shiva说的是正确的。白坤塔之主，白坤塔的至尊主和主Shiva是没有是无二无别的，正如Gauri主Shiva的妻子Gauri和幸运女神Ramadevi二者是无二无别。And
the Vaikunthavasis say we know Lord Shiva and his wife. They can live in Vaikuntha if they want, because it's their place. They're the friend of the Lord. They're his incarnation. We know that Lord Shiva is just speaking this way out of humility. It's just the mood of a devotee to be very humble. So this is why the Vaishnavas all praise Lord Shiva, and that his mood inspires people to take up devotional service.
正因如此，人们，Vaishnava们都赞扬主Shiva，因为他的心态就鼓励了人们来开始奉爱服务。Among
all the Lord's incarnations, Lord Shiva is the greatest.
在主的众多化身之中，主Shiva是最伟大、最了不起的。So
Lord Shiva, when he heard himself praised, He did not say anything. He just bowed his head. And then the people from Vaikuntha, they were all Lord Shiva's friends, they embraced Gop Kumar. Lord
Shiva 朋友，这些白昆塔的居民们就拥抱了罗帕库玛。And
they told Gop Kumar, "We also count you among the Lord's devotees. Oh, you're the son of a cowherd boy from Vrindavan, but we count you as one of the Lord's devotees."
这些白昆塔瓦斯告诉罗帕库玛，我们把你也算作主的奉献者之一。 你身为牧牛童波丹山牧牛童牧牛郎的儿子，也被算作了主的奉献者。And
we know your guru. We know your guru. He's also an incarnation of God.
我们知道您的guru也是神的化身。So
we came here for you, for your sake. We want to encourage you. We want you to go to Vaikuntha.
我们此番前来，特地是为了您而来，是为了鼓励您去Vaikuntha。We
want you to come to Vaikuntha, and there you can practice the nine kinds of devotional service, beginning with hearing and chanting.
我们鼓励您去买昆塔，在那里从事九种奉爱服务，从聆听和唱诵开始。
You will hear the Bhagavatam, and you will hear all the Lord's pastimes, and you will hear all these different incarnations, when all these different pastimes, when they enter your ears, you will feel so much pleasure.
And
when you hear these things, then you will want to go to Vaikuntha.
Hmm.
So just simply by doing devotional service, this is how you can easily achieve the Vaikuntha. You can get the ultimate goal, enter Vaikuntha.
仅仅是通过履行奉爱服务，就能够轻而易举地达到终极的目标Vaikuntha。Everything
else, any other thing which may be told in the scriptures, different powers or blessings, they're nothing compared to entering Vaikuntha.
在别的地方经典、别的经典里所描记述的种种的力量啊，种种的祝福，都无法跟去Vaikuntha比美。In
Vaikuntha, then you can taste the sweetness of devotional service.
在Vaikuntha可以品尝到做奉爱服务的甜美。
Even you engage in even one of the nine kinds of devotional service, you can develop pure love for the Lord. And if you are attracted to other gods other than the Supreme Lord Vishnu, then this is just like a disease, which will never give you peace or happiness. You have to keep the heart pure without any other desire, only to worship the Supreme Lord.
你必须让你的内心纯洁无瑕，没有其他的愿望，只是想要崇拜至尊主。
And when we worship the Lord like that, then wherever we are, the Lord will appear, and that place will become just like Vaikuntha.
如果以这种方式崇拜主的话，无论我们去哪里，那个地方就显得就像Vaikuntha一样。
But still, we should know that the Vaikuntha world, that is the supreme abode, and it's only there that the Lord is always seen by His devotees. So in this way, the Vaikuntha Vasis are speaking to Gop Kumar, they're encouraging him to come to Vaikuntha. Okay, so we'll hear more next time. Okay, are there any questions?
接下来我们看一下有没有问题。第一个好像是，拜拜金人。第一个问题是，看一下他的吧，大师，顶戴马哈拉者和奉献者。 第一个问题是，唐加大巴在顶拜马哈拉者奉献者波巴库马各处旅行，得到的好的涟漪。很多奉献者不能旅行去圣地，也不能旅行到莱峰塔。如何追随波巴库马的步伐呢？ Obeisance to Maharaj and devotees, Bhopakuma can travel everywhere and get good association. Yet many devotees cannot travel to Holy Dham and cannot travel to Vaikuntha. How can they follow the footsteps of Gopakumar?
Well, we follow by taking the instructions which we have received. Right? There's two ways to associate. There is the vani and there is the vapu. There is the instruction and there is the physical form.
有两种联谊方式有两种一种是瓦密一种是瓦库一种是通过遵守遵行信誓来得到联谊另外一种呢就是天生的联谊。
The body is not eternal. We cannot expect to associate with the body for very long.
躯体不是永恒的, 我们不能指望着
The guru and the devotees, we all have material bodies, and one day we will give up the material body. So we cannot simply depend on the body for association. We have to take shelter of the instructions. Just like Arjuna, he was fortunate, he got Lord Krishna's association. But then Lord Krishna disappeared from the planet. And then Arjuna was helpless for some time because he had no more, he was always depending on Krishna. But after Krishna had gone, then he understood that he had to take shelter of Krishna's instructions.
正如Arjuna当主Krishna隐迹之后感到非常的无助因为他之前是完全依赖着Krishna可是现在Krishna走了他后来明白到他要脱避于主Krishna的姓氏
The instructions are eternal, but the physical form, that's very temporary. So it's important for us to develop the attachment to the instruction.
And here, 非常重要的一点是要依附于训示。Prabhupada
described he only met his spiritual master 4 or 5 times.
是的,Prabhupada说他只是见过自己的领导是四五面。But
he never forgot his instructions.
但是他从未忘记过灵云导师的训示。And
he kept the instructions of this guru in his heart.
他把这些训示牢牢地牢记在心中。And
he always followed the instructions of his guru.
他始终遵行guru的训示。So
we have to also take shelter of the instructions.
我们也要始终脱离于训示。We
have all of Prabhupada's books and his lectures and so many letters. We have many things to take shelter of.
我们有吃了Prabhupada的书籍、讲座、信件，有许多可以脱避的。
So this way we're always have association. These things can always be with us. They're there to guide us. We cannot just simply depend, oh, devotee should be there, I need physical, I need somebody with me all the time. No, you have to feel Krishna is always with you.
我们不能指望着一直依赖着奉献者和我一直在一起。不是的，Krishna总是在那里。And
you should feel also spiritual masters also with you. When you're representing him, he's with you, guiding you, leading you.
也是感受到灵性导师也是始终在那里，一旦您代表着灵性导师，他就在那里指导着你。
He's just like Prabhupada said, it's in my spiritual master's always by my side, leading me.
正像舍勒帕巴说的，我的灵性导师始终在我的身旁带领着我。
I was listening, one devotee was speaking, he was describing how Prabhupada came to San Francisco and the temple was packed, and it was all the devotees in the temple, they were all in saffron cloth, you know, and many brahmacharis and some sannyasis were also there.
庙里呢挤满着穿着那些橘黄袍子的奉献者，因为当时那里很多的 Brahmachari 正手生和Sannyasi徒步僧。
So when Prabhupada came there to the door, he stopped at the door and waited there for some time. So then devotees asked Prabhupada, "What's wrong?" And Prabhupada said, "I'm showing my Guru Maharaj. I want my Guru Maharaj to see this."
当释迦牟尼到达门口了之后，他在那里等了一会儿，停了一会儿。奉献者们就问释迦牟尼的：“有什么问题吗？”释迦牟尼回答说：“我在展示给我的灵性导师所有这些奉献者们。”
Because Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati, he had been a lifelong brahmachari, and then later on he took sannyas, so he was very, he liked to see.Devotee in saffron cloth, he liked to see the people also taking vows of some kind of renunciation.
Because Bhaktisiddhanta Sarasvati was a living living
You know, if you're the only one in saffron and everybody else is not in saffron, you feel uncomfortable. But if everyone's in saffron, then you feel very nice, you feel happy. So Prabhupada, like that, he was showing all the devotees, all these brahmacharis, sannyasis, he wanted to show his Guru Maharaj. It was like his Guru Maharaj was actually with him, and he was showing this to him. He said, "Look at this, just see, so many brahmacharis, so many sannyasis."
所以释迦牟尼，巴布帕德，他就喜欢展示给他的咕噜，所有这些真正生这些波波僧，就好，他们在一起，让他的领导人看，有这么多真正生，有这么多的三加四。
Okay.
下一个问题是来自于。主机 YY 新人 ，Hare Krishna， 明白 Guru Maharaj， Guru Shotama 月即将来临，请教 Guru Deva， 我们每天什么时间崇拜，什么时间崇拜主最好？需要念诵什么祷文以及崇拜的具体步骤？感恩 Guru Deva。Recently, because Purushottama month is coming soon, I'd like to know when is the best time to worship the Lord and what prayer should we chant? And also, what's the specific steps to worship?
Uh-huh. Well, Purushottam Yuga is meant for people, you know, is to encourage people who are not devotees to take up devotional service. But for someone who's already a devotee, it's not a big deal, there's no change. You just continue as you are. So the best time to worship the Lord is during the Brahma Muhurta, which is 1.5 hours before sunrise. Right. If the sun rises at 6 o'clock in the morning, then you want to do the Mangal Arti, do the puja 4:30 in the morning. And the best prayers to chant? Well, one prayer which is often chanted at this particular time are the prayers offered by Lord Brahma after he had stolen the cows away. I think it's chapter 13 in the 10th canto, Srimad Bhagavatam. So, but any prayer, usually we chant, you know, every day we chant Guru Vastikam. We first approach the spiritual master, and by the mercy of the spiritual master, we get the mercy of Krishna. So during this Purushottam month, they give special benefits for people. You know, if you do more puja, you get more benefit. They say you get 1,000 times the benefit than any other time. So during this month, people will try to chant more rounds, they will try to do more service. And this is a very inauspicious time. Purushottam month is very inauspicious for all material activities. And so we avoid all kinds of materialistic affairs and just concentrate on spiritual activities. Okay. How to worship Lord Shiva to get rid of false ego?
Yes.
Well, we can worship Lord Shiva by chanting the holy name. By chanting the holy name of Lord Krishna, you can worship Lord Shiva, because Lord Shiva himself takes pleasure in chanting the Lord's holy name.
We can worship Lord Krishna by chanting the holy name of Lord Krishna. 因为主持人自己也喜欢念诵圣名。
Lord Shiva has a form with five faces. Panchamukhi, Mahadevo Panchamukhi. Lord Shiva has one, he's known as Mahadev, the greatest of gods, and he has a form with five faces, and each of the faces are chanting Rama, Rama, Hari, Hari. And Lord Shiva also told his wife to chant the holy name of Lord Ram. So if we chant the holy name of Lord Krishna, certainly it will be very pleasing to Lord Shiva. And we chant the name of Lord Shiva and the name of Lord Krishna, understanding that it's the desire of Lord Shiva, that Lord Shiva has asked us to do this. So we're doing it for his pleasure. So we don't need to separately worship Lord Shiva. We just have to understand how Lord Shiva is non-different from Lord Krishna. And by worshipping Lord Krishna, then we're also pleasing Lord Shiva. But some people, they don't understand, and they think Shiva, they think everybody is, you know, the, when we say Lord Shiva is non-different from Krishna, we mean, in some senses he's the same, but in other senses he's different. It's like one and different. They're individuals, but at the same time different.
Some people doesn't understand, and they think Lord Shiva is not different from Lord Krishna.
Yeah, so he is. There are differences. At the same time, there's oneness. There's a oneness, but there's also a difference.
So, 有的人他们不明白，就是主Shiva和主Krishna之间有一些。 不同，但是也有一致的地方，所以他们是第一记忆的。
Some people think all the gods are one. They make that mistake, and they think there's no difference.
有的人认为所有的神祇都是一，他们就犯了错误。
Oh, but there is a difference. There is a difference that Lord Shiva is a personality and Lord Krishna is a personality, and different personalities.
但是他们是有区别的。主 Shiva
是一个人物，主
Krishna 是另外一个人物。
Now Lord Shiva, he is an incarnation of the Lord, and he's the greatest, the best of all the incarnations. But at the same time, he's different from the Lord.
主Shiva是主最好的化身，他是主Shiva的化身，但是同时主Shiva和主还是有分别的。So
we just have to worship Lord Krishna, and by worshipping Lord Krishna, then Lord Shiva is very satisfied.
我们只需要崇拜主Krishna，我们崇拜了主Krishna，主Shiva就会感到非常的满意。
Lord Shiva told his wife, of all kinds of worship, the worship of Vishnu is the supreme, is the best. So we worship Lord Krishna. Lord Krishna is the original form of Vishnu. Vishnu is the expansion coming from Krishna. But the worship of Krishna is confidential. It's not known by everyone. So we're very fortunate that we have been given this very special knowledge. That we can understand the importance of pure devotional service. It's a very confidential thing. So Lord Shiva, he will give mercy, a cheating potency. He will give people, he will fulfill their material desires, or he will give them impersonal liberation. But when he wants to give his greatest mercy, that's pure devotion, devotional service to worship Krishna. But he rarely gives that. So we want to get rid of false ego. We can take shelter of Lord Shiva by chanting the holy name of Lord Krishna. Okay.
下一个问题是来自于，依然是半影像，主西瓦额头上的半月标志，主西瓦额头上的半月标志有什么来头吗？ Are there any reason why Lord Shiva has this half moon on his head? How does it come? Where does it come from? What's the source?
Yes. What happened was when the demigods and the demons were churning the ocean of milk, at one point they produced poison. They wanted to produce nectar. But before the nectar came, first of all, poison came. So Lord Shiva was asked to drink the poison. So Lord Shiva, when he drank all the poison, then his throat became blue, and because he drank all the poison, his body became very hot. So the crescent moon was put on his head, that was given to him to cool him down from the heat of all the poison which he drank.
When 他的身体浑身感到非常的灼热，所以就把这个半月放在他的头上，好清凉，因毒液而导致的灼烧感。
So that crescent moon was given to him in gratitude for him drinking all the poison to keep him cool.
所以这个半月就被赐予祖师了，来表达对他喝下了毒液的感恩之情，好让他变得凉爽。
还有问题吗？
还有下一个问题是，淡然一笑，灵性世界的萨拉西瓦有妻子吗？Does Sadashiva also have wife in the spiritual world?
Does Lord Shiva have a wife in the spiritual world?
Sadashiva
Of
is devotee.
Sadashiva. Well, yeah, he will have a consort.
是的。
I'm not sure what her name is, but I don't see why not. Everyone else has their consort. All the other deities there, you know, they all have their consorts. Lord Nrsingadev has his consort, Lakshmi, the goddess of fortune. So if Sahadashiva is none different from Vishnu, then the goddess of fortune is also his consort.
不知道他的名字是什么，但是在灵性界，每一个神子都有自己的伴侣，比如 Nrsingadev 有他的伴侣 Lakshmi Devi，而 Sadashiva 跟主 Vishnu 没有分别，因此性女神就是他的伴侣。
Yeah, people, and just like in the material world, people like to have a wife, or a woman likes to have a husband, you know, they're happy together. Usually, and of course, now Kali Yuga, people are not so happy together, they quarrel with each other and argue and they get divorced. But usually, it's more natural that they would be happy together, live together as a family.
物质世界也有那么多的夫妻，女人也想得到一位丈夫，一般他们都有这种愿望。但在那个年代呢，因为有这么多的争吵，有分居啊、离婚呢、在家一般来说呢，就有一个家是会令人感到愉悦的。
So in the spiritual world, there's no divorce. They have their consort, they live together happily, peacefully, and they have all their devotees, their family.
在灵性世界没有离婚，所以呢，就这些伴侣们呢，平和快乐的生活在一起，他们都是奉献者。
还有问题？
下一个问题来自于拉扎尔的兄弟，Hare Krishna，听听你的亲爱的劝播吗？请问一位普通奉献者，一位普通奉献者，他既不纯粹又没有完美的知识，这样奉献者在离开躯体时候，应该注意些什么才能避免危险的结果呢？感恩主持人。
If someone is not perfect in knowledge, what do they need to do at the time of death? The knowledge is not perfect. What do they need to pay attention to at the time of death, at the time of leaving their body,
Yes.
so that they can get the ultimate perfection?
To avoid the difficult result, dangerous result to avoid.
The main thing is to take forgiveness from all the devotees that beg forgiveness that you may have offended anybody. Please forgive me.
主要的事情就是恳求原谅，恳求奉献者向他们恳求他们，如果我曾经做过冒犯的话，请宽恕我。
We want to thank the devotees for their association and for their service, and express our gratitude to them and appreciation for them, and beg forgiveness.
For 我们要，我们感激奉献者的怜悯，我们向奉献者表达感恩之情，感谢他们的怜悯，感谢他们的服务。如果曾经做过任何冒犯的话，也可得到奉献者的宽恕。
I think that's the most important thing before leaving the world. We want to be sure that there's no bad feelings towards anyone. We have no bitterness towards anyone.
我想这个是在离开世界的时候最重要的事情。我们不希望任何人对我们有不好的感觉。我们也不希望内心存有对任何人的那种不良的感受，痛苦的感觉。
Then we can leave the world peacefully.
这样就可以平和地离开世界了。
We want to be attached to hearing the holy name and to remembering the spiritual teachers.
我们希望能够依附聆听圣名，能够记忆着灵性导师。
Srila Prabhupada showed us his example how to leave the world. He had one devotee read from his spiritual master's book to him.
Srila Prabhupada 展示了离开这个世界的榜样，他让一位奉献者给他朗读他的灵性导师的书籍。
At the same time, he had a picture of the deities in front of him, and he had the garland from the deities around his neck.
同时，将神像的照片放在眼前，并且佩戴着神像不戴过的花环。
And he had the devotees all chanting his holy name, the holy name of the Lord. Okay.
下一个问题，下一个问题来自于 Durangi Dedasi， 明白孤入，明白奉献者吗？孤您刚才说想去晚餐塔，要有主持的。Gorangi， 要有主 Shiva 的仁慈才能去晚婚的，有主 Shiva 的100倍才能到晚婚的。我这么堕落还不规范，那岂不是回不去吗？回不去的话，就还要转世是吗？就还要转世，请孤入指导哈尔克什。Just mentioned we need Lord Shiva's mercy to go back to spiritual world, and 100 times the mercy of Lord Shiva, they only get 100 times the mercy that Lord Shiva gets.Can we go to Vaikuntha? But I'm so fallen and not so regulated. So then I cannot go back. Then I have to reincarnate in the material world. Is that so? I beg to get guidance on Guru.
No, it's not so. Because you have the mercy of Lord Chaitanya. Lord Chaitanya is the most merciful of all Krishna's incarnations.And he comes to give us all the Sankirtan movement, the chanting of the holy name.
不是的，因为你有主 Chaitanya 的仁慈，而主 Chaitanya 是主 Krishna 的化身，他到降临给予了世人当 Kirtan 即诵圣名运动。
Yeah, by the mercy of Lord Chaitanya, then we can all go back to Godhead.
即使主 Chaitanya 的仁慈，我们都可以归神手。
So we have to take part in the chanting of the holy name. Then it's very natural and easy for us to go back to Godhead.
因此，我们都要参与唱诵圣名，这样回归神手就自然而然也变得轻而易举了。
So that is the greatest mercy.
这是最伟大的、最了不起的仁慈。
Lord Chaitanya has made it very easy for all of us in the Kali Yuga that we can go back to Godhead.
主产生量，让卡利年代的我们非常容易的就能回到神手身边。
Any other question?
下一个问题，Dati 对 Dati，应该不是对吧？请问是不是每个回归的奉献者都要像 Gopakumar 一样穿越所有宇宙和不同 Loka 呢？在我们的宇宙和 Loka 都有那么强大吸引力，我们是否有能力不被这些吸引而直接回归到 Goloka Vrindavan 呢？Is that every devotee who will go back to Godhead has to undergo all the experience of Gopakumar to go through all the universe and different lokas, and in each universe and loka, they are so attractive. Do we have the ability to be not attracted and to go back directly?
Yes, interesting. Yeah, interesting question. Actually, it's a fact that before we go back to Godhead, on the way back to Godhead, we don't have to spend a long time there, but we have to go past them, we have to go by them, it's on the way back to Godhead.
非常的有趣。事实上呢，就是在我们回归神手的路上，我们是要经过的，但是我们不需要长时间的待在那里。但是他们确实是在这个回到神手的路上，必经之路。
So this book has been written by Sanatan Goswami just to help us overcome that. That when we go back to Godhead, we won't be attracted to all these other places.
咱们都说阿弥就著作的这本书籍，就是为了帮助我们克服克服这个倾向，好让我们回归神手的路上不会受到吸引。
If we simply, hear this knowledge, how it's been described here. We can see everything, how Gopkumar, he's visiting all these places. He doesn't find anything really attractive there. He just wants Madan Gopal. He just wants devotional service. He just wants the land of Vrindavan. That's the ultimate place.
我们聆听到这门知识，就能得到，就能知道，就是在书中描述的，多帕库马他虽然拜访了所有这些地方，但是发现他们并不具备真正，他们并不是真的那么有吸引力，不像马丹多帕，还有不像奉献服务那么有吸引力，像文达文那么吸引力。
So we have to learn not to be attracted to any of these things in the material world.
我们要学会不被物质世界的这些任何的事物所吸引，
And
够好了。
we shouldn't even be attracted to this place of liberation, the bright light, the effulgence, the opulence of the impersonal Brahman.
我们要学会不被解脱之地所吸引，不被白光所吸引，不被非人格的术语所吸引。
Yeah, if we're still attracted to these things, yeah, we still have some material desires. We'll go there. So we have to get rid of these material desires while we're here in this world. This is our preparation to go back to Godhead, to get rid of these desires. But if we're still thinking there's something we didn't enjoy, we want to enjoy something there in the material world, then we'll stay here in the material world.
我们要是想着，哎，在物质世界还有些事物还没有享受完呢，那我们就要留在这个物质世界。
嗯，OK。
下一个问题是来自于大庆的苏尔比，应该估计，塔拉提和萨提是同一个人吗？主师傅有几个妻子啊？为什么还有个叫乌玛的？今天您讲课又提到一个叫高瑞的，他们都是主师傅妻子吗？是同一个人吗
？Yeah, Lord Shiva only has one wife, but they have different names.
主师傅只有一名妻子，一位妻子，但是他有很多名字。
Yeah, sometimes she's called Sati, sometimes she's Parvati.Sometimes she's Uma.
有的时候她被称为 Sati, 有的时候被称为 Parvati, 有的时候又被叫做 Uma.
And so, even we can have different names. You can have, you know, somewhere they call you one name, another place you have another name. Somewhere they call you teacher, somewhere you're, you know, mother, somewhere you're, you know, have different names. Those,Not uncommon.
我们在不同的地方呢，也被换有不同的称呼。有的时候我们被称为老师，有的时候我们又被称呼为妈妈。所以呢，就在不同的地方会有不同的称号。
So these names of Lord Shiva's wife are according to her qualities and her different.Characteristics.
主师傅的这些，主师傅的妻子之所以被称作这些不同的名字，是根据他的不同的品质以及不同的特征来被呼唤的。
Okay.
没有问题了。上面漏了一个问题。Devati, Devati Madaji 问梵歌当中说超越物质三属性才能在 Krishna 直觉之中。我们现在还没有在 Krishna 直觉之中，可以去传播吗？
In Bhagavad Gita, that only by transcending the three modes of material nature can we be situated in Krishna consciousness. And now we don't have Krishna consciousness yet. Can we spread Krishna consciousness?
Well, if you repeat what you have heard from the authorities, then you can spread Krishna consciousness.
如果您只是重复从权威那里听到了，就可以传播 Krishna 知觉。
Just like you say you're not Krishna conscious, but if you repeat what Prabhupada said in his books, then that is perfect knowledge, and he is Krishna conscious.
您提到您没有Krishna之觉，但是Prabhupada的书籍是有着完美的知识。如果您仅仅重复，就是传播的，就是在传播Krishna之觉了。
So we may not be Krishna conscious, but that doesn't mean the knowledge which we are giving is not perfect. Because we're passing on the knowledge coming from perfect persons, coming from Krishna and from Krishna's pure devotees. So we're like a postman. The postman delivers the message. Postman may not be perfect, but he delivers the mail. He's doing a good job.
就像邮递员，邮递员自己可能是不完美的，但是他只要把这个邮件递到了，他就是完美了。
So we're like a postman on behalf of our spiritual teachers. We pass on the knowledge we receive from them.
Mm-hmm.
没有问题了，Gurudev。没有。今天的问题都解答完了。OK。感谢您的精彩解答，礼拜你。好，敬拜你们，谢谢那，那Guru Mani，感谢您的服务。谢谢Maharaj。OK，have a good day，thank you very much，Srila Prabhupada ki。Jai。Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki。Jai。
Hare Krishna. 好，那我们今天的早课就到这里结束了。感谢奉献者的聆听和提出来的好问题。Hare Krishna.